Any other thing there? 4 to 6 months. Okay, and then you see that your implant failed. Okay, you can send us. Okay, and we will change it for you. Okay, so that's the life warranty. And for example, so we have for nervous integration and manufacture defect. Okay, normally with nervous integration. Okay, so we can change it for you. There is one thing just that we need, because that first certification that I showed you, you have to send us with a form, okay? The X-ray before you take the implant off, okay? If it fails, if you have the fibrous tissue around, okay? And the implant tube. You have to send us these three things, okay, for us to change it for you. There are not much bureaucracy, okay, but we need this because of that first certification, because every 3 months they arrive and look all the folders in the company to see if the certification, to see if the life warranty is good, all the forms are complete with the x-rays and everything. So the bureaucracy is for us, not for you, okay? So you just need. So when you lose an implant, you can send us and we will change it for you. We talk about precision. Why we talk about precision? Because that both machines that I showed you, okay, we work with centesimal of millimeters of precision, okay? So it's too much precision, okay? That's why we use that much machines. Another interesting thing is that we work with this controlled passivity. What is controlled passivity? Let's remember tomorrow a little. I talked to you about titanium, yeah? About the oxygen layer. There is an important thing that I didn't tell you. I forgot. In titanium, okay, in the implant, in the surface of the implant, normally on the tread, you cannot touch with other type of metal. Okay? You cannot. Why you cannot? Because when you touch, you change ions. Okay, ions? You change ions between these two metals. Okay? If you change these ions in that area where you touch it with other metal, okay, you will not have osseointegration. Okay? So, how we manufacture an implant? We have a bar, like a 3, 4, 5 meters bar with a diameter. It passes for the machine. It will be designed. And after that, we have the implant. Okay. But this bar comes touching other metals. This implant come touching other metals until it will be in the back. The back, okay? But before we put it inside the package, okay, of the implant, we have to work with this contour passivity. What is this contour passivity? We have to equalize the ions of the surface of the implant. And how we do it? We make like a little treatment of acid, okay, acid. And this acid will take off all the superficial layer of the yazdum, okay, will take off, and when you took it up, you have another yazdum layer. Okay, did you understand that? And this new layer, you have an equalized yazdum layer. Okay, did you understand? After that, this implant touched nothing anymore, all in the package. Very good? Did you understand? Doubts? No? Okay. That's the control passivity. It's very, very important to have, okay? So, this is an osseointegration. This is what we want when we place an implant inside the bone. Here you can see the hex, and here you can see the threads, okay? And this bone, too much bone. That's what we want, okay? And this is too interesting too, because it's an implant of us, okay? And here you can see the surface of the implant, a roughness surface. You can see the roughness surface here, yeah? That's it. This is a roughness surface. Okay, it's not a flat one. And here you can see a osteoblast cell, an osteoblast cell, practically attacking the surface of the implant. Okay, that's it. That's what this type of response is what we want. Okay? Yesterday I didn't show you that the roughness surface. That's it. This is a roughness surface. Okay? Nowadays we changed some few things because of the some research proved something for us and for all of the world of implantology. And we made some changes in our implants according to the research. First, we are working with double thread. What is double thread? It appears that you have two threads in one implant. Okay? Imagine here. Here you have the implant. And imagine that. Here I have one thread. Okay? And between these, you have another thread. Okay? Individual thread here. So this is with this, and this is with this. This with this, and this with this. Did you understand? They are individuals. Advantages for it. More primary stability, okay? And it's faster. Because if you give one turn, you are given two turns because you have two threads. So it goes down faster. So the surgery becomes a little bit faster. Okay? Conic point, this apical point, okay, we changed it too. It was like this. It was like this. Nowadays it's like this. Okay? On the point. Why? Easier to place in the site, the surgical site. Okay? And another important thing. When this conic point arrives in the top or in the bottom of the site, it starts to make like a bone compression, a very good bone compression. And this will give you the primary stability, a better primary stability too. Okay? So this is some change. These are some changes that make difference. More primary stability, sure. Bone expansion because of the apical part. yesterday I said you that implants from Brandon Mark normally used to have like a neck here, like this. Have the platform, okay, and a neck like this. So this is a fragile part of the implant, okay, because when you have excessive power, you may fracture this area. What we've done is to do like this. Can you see the difference? Yeah? So it's not too fragile anymore. Okay? And more insertion facility because of this conic point. This conic point makes difference. Who knew the old types of implants, okay? They, like a squared one. Knows that this conic point is too much better. You feel it easy during the surgery, okay? Another thing that I want to show you is this one, this type of implant. It's called silver implant, our silver implant, okay? We have a new thread design. You can see that's a more stronger, this thread, okay? You have double thread tube, okay? And the most important function of this thread is to have more primary stability, okay? So, you can see, every time we talk about primary stability. So you can see that's so important during the surgery, okay? That's it, that's called the silver implant, okay? Okay, let's talk about the diameters of the implants. Well, we have MP narrow platform. Okay, when I use this narrow platform implants, normally in teeth with a small diameter, okay? Normally in areas where we have teeth with a small diameter. Why? Because this implant has 3.3 millimeters only of diameter, okay? This one, SM, okay? And this one is a little bit different. Why? Because the MB, you have a small diameter and a small platform, okay? So, you have a small diameter and a small platform, like this. You have 3.3 of the body diameter, and you have 3.5 of the platform. So, you have the implant
here.
When arrive the platform, it does like this, a little bit. Do you understand? So you have 3.3 here, and here you have 3.5, okay? This other one, SM, you have the body 3.32, but here you don't have the narrow platform. You have the standard platform, the regular platform. So you have 3.3 in the body, but you have 4.1 in the platform, okay? This 4.1 is called regular platform, okay? Every time that we talk about regular platform, we are talking about 4.1, okay? This SP, standard platform or regular platform, okay, these both two, we have with diameter 3.75 millimeters and 4 millimeters, okay? And both of these, we have regular platform. We have 4.1. So let's think. We have 3.75 body and make a little open to 4.1. Okay? Always that we have S before, we have regular platform. Okay? 4.1. And here too, we have 4 millimeters diameter of the body of the implant, and it opens just a little to 4.1. Did you understand that? Okay? Doubts? No? And this last case, we have a wide platform implant. Okay? We have 5 millimeters of the body, 5 millimeters, and we have 5.1 of the platform. Okay? So, it's a big one, a strong one. Okay? Here is just to see and to show you that in the platform, that is this, like this neck, okay? We have 3.5. The body is 3.3, but the platform is 3.5. It's important for you to know, because we have to see where we are going to place the implants, okay, according to the teeth. And other important thing, when you call for the dealer to ask for an abutment, you have to know which platform you are using, okay? If it's a narrow neck, a regular neck, or a wide neck platform, okay? That's very important, okay? This regular platform, you can see we have 4.1 millimeters, okay? And the last one, we have 5.1, but the body is 5, okay? Let's see before a little, for you to understand. Here you have the body, so in this case we have a 3.75 millimeters body, okay, here, but in the platform is this neck, okay, you have 4.1. Did you see the difference? Okay, so this platform is basic, okay, when we talk about Predmark regular platform, we are talking about 4.1. Okay? Let's see a case. This case, we've done in our long practice. Okay? A root fracture, okay? With resorption, we need to remove it and to place an implant immediately. Starting, remove the teeth, when you talk about implants, you always have to think in maintain a lot, okay, soft tissue and hard tissue, okay, you have to preserve a lot this both tissues. Start with the extraction. I think it's better to turn on the light. Oh, very good. Thank you. Okay. Here you can see a letter, okay, the tooth extracted. You can see the resorption.